family, welcome and welcome back to the channel. I hope you're all doing great. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you how to make stuffed onions and stuffed tomatoes that are really perfect for breakfast. You can add them to your plain bread or toast. They are really good. Let's get to today's video. So I already prepared my onions. All I'm going to do now is just cut them into rings as shown in the video. So for the rings, they don't have to be really thin. They can be a quarter inch. Yeah, that's perfect. So after that, I'm just going to separate the rings as shown in the video. And for the rest of the onions that cannot make the rings, you're just going to chop them. We are going to use them. So I used 2 onions. Moving on, I'm also going to do the same with my tomatoes. I used 2 medium-sized tomatoes too. So for the tomatoes, after cutting them into rings, all I'm going to do is to remove the inside of the tomato. If the tomato is really ripe, you can just use a spoon to scoop it, or you can do as I've done in the video. So for the rest of the tomatoes that will not make the rings, you're going to chop them like I've done in the video. We are going to use them. So as you've seen, our rings are ready. I'm going to set them aside. Moving on, I'm going to show you all the ingredients that you're going to use to make our vegetable mixture. I have some black pepper to taste. You're going to add that to bring some heat to it. I have 4 medium-sized eggs. I also have some green pepper and 1 medium-sized grated carrot. So the tomato that we chopped, I added it to that silver bowl, and then all I did was to add all the vegetables as shown in the video. And then all I'm going to do is to just add my 4 eggs. I'm going to break my eggs and then add them to the bowl. I'm going to add my pepper to taste, my black pepper, I'm sorry, to taste, to give it a little heat, I'm sorry again. I'm also going to add my salt to taste, yes. And then all I'm going to do is to give my vegetable mixture a really good mix. I'm going to set that aside. Moving on to my preheated pan, I'm going to add my oil, and then all I'm going to do is to just, we are going to start by preparing our stuffed onion rings. You can start with whichever you want. So I'm going to add my rings to my pan as shown in the video, and then I'm going to add my vegetable mixture to each ring as shown in the video. So you don't have to worry so much about the eggs that are going to be on the side of your rings. You're going to fix that. So I'm going to cook both the first side of my onion rings, my stuffed onion rings, yeah, for 2 to 3 minutes, and then all I'm going to do is to flip the other side again and cook it for at least 1 to 2 minutes. I think that will be perfect. So you have to check on them so that the egg doesn't burn, and again your heat has to be low when making this. So like I've said before, these are really perfect with that toast. I already did a video on how to make cabbage toast. So I made toast. It was literally how to make toast, something like that. You can go check it out with the So it's all about how to make a toast without a toaster on a frying pan, something like that. So again, when our onion rings are ready, when our stuffed onion rings are ready, I'm going to set them aside, and then all I'm going to do is to just repeat the process with our tomatoes. I'm going to add my oil to my pan. The oil, you are going to just lightly oil your pan, And then what I'm going to do is to add my vegetable mixture as shown in the video. And then I'm going to cook the first side, like I've said, for 2 to 3 minutes. And then I'm going to flip the other side and cook it for at least 2 to 3 minutes again for the tomatoes. So these are really, really good, you guys. And like I've said, you can try them out with plain bread. Plain bread is so perfect. And also, if you love toast, you can toast your bread and put them in between. They are so good. So I hope you love the video. Let me know what you think about it, about the video, in the comment section below. Kindly subscribe to my channel for more videos. Yeah, so right now, as you can see, my stuffed tomatoes are really ready, and I love these stuffed tomatoes. They are like, when you heat them, they melt in your mouth. That's what I loved about them. So like I said, you don't have to worry about the eggs that are on the side. You're just going to use a fork or a spoon to remove the eggs that are on the side, and you're not going to throw the eggs away. You can use them on your bread again. Yeah, so you don't have to do this step if you are heating this at home, but I had to do it because I want to make them more presentable, something like that. Thanks for watching. See you in my next video. Bye.